So it's Tuesday, the 3rd of October. But of course, it's the first business day and the market trading day for all of us here in Nigeria. Let's get you started with the latest from FBN Quest regarding Nigeria's manufacturing data for the month of September. We finished just about 4 days ago. The reading, according to this report, is a little weaker, quote unquote, 58.1 in September against 58.3, just about 0.02 basis points lower than we had. That's what FBN Quest released earlier today. Of course, we had the Central Bank of Nigeria's PMI data or report before we went for the Independence Day holiday, showing some consecutive month strong reading. But the PMI independent data says this index was down slightly to 58.1 against 58.3 in the month, or 58.5, beg your pardon, in the month of August. Of course, this is a forward-looking economic data, and of course, 3 of the 5 sub-indices measured by FBN Quest, which is an independent report in September, were all in positive territory. The reading has been above 50 since March 2017. The report says among the 5 sub-indices, there's a small improvement in output, but a very particularly strong reading of 60 in new orders. That is, manufacturers were making new orders. Again, that speaks to the central bank's foreign exchange FX sales rapidly, in particular since April the 21st, 2017, and that flew into the manufacturing data that we saw in the second quarter with the GDP reading 0.6%. That's the GDP and the manufacturing 0.6% year on year in the second quarter. According to this report, Nigeria now out of recession. Of course, if you look at around the world, Nigeria's September PMI, although a little bit weaker at 58.1 in September, was better than Brazil, 50.9. Little bit higher than China at 52.4 reading and 51.9 reading PMI for Russia, and the same reading, 58.1 for the Eurozone, but the highest PMI reading for September, as reported, is for the United States, 60.7. Nigeria's PMI still on track, but slightly weaker in September. Now we're done with the third quarter, but we'll have a lot to review this week about the third quarter of the year. But let's step into the fourth quarter, which is where we're starting officially today when we're done with the Independence holiday. The equities market was down 0.18% last month versus a strongly bullish second quarter in the index reading for the stock market. The third quarter earnings releases is expected to be part of the trading theme for the new quarter, the final in 2017, including the manufacturing data that we've just got in the September reading, both from the central bank and another independent from FBN Quest. Then, of course, September inflation report is expected from the 13th of the new month. Meantime, investors in fixed income, treasury bills and bonds will watch very closely the new $5.5 billion Eurobond package of the Nigerian government. Eurobond package, $2.5 billion. The Naira dollar treasury refinancing that was spoken about by the Ministry of Finance will be about 3.5%, 3.5 billion in the fourth quarter. And of course, we're expecting a yet to be disclosed diaspora bond also in the fourth quarter. All that could take the Nigeria's foreign borrowings outside any more multilateral borrowings to about $6 billion dollars for the final quarter of the current year. Now, investors are likely, and traders surprising, the likely do nothing November Central Bank Monetary Policy Committee meeting. A number of central banks around the world are leaving interest rates unchanged and watching the United States Fed very closely as to what Janet Yellen will do in December. So it looks like everyone will keep their fingers off the rate button until then. This morning, the Reserve Bank of Australia, reported leaving interest rate unchanged at 1.5%. Meantime, the central bank is also expected to wait out the rally in the FX market. We've seen a Naira dollar very strongly this year with a rapid sale of FX into the market or into the various segments of the market. And the investors and exporters window trading nearly $10 billion since the beginning of the new year, in particular since the third week of April, when that window was open for investors who want to trade whatever they are doing. And of course, exporters who want to trade in their dollars into the marketplace. Meantime, we're asking the question, where is the green bond that was spoke about very well last year and the early part of 2017? So will the green bond, Nigeria's green bond, still materialize before the end of the year? We're looking at the Ministry of Environment to bring us up to speed on that. Meantime, the bigger focus for this quarter will be the fiscal authorities, the Nigerian authorities, capital expenditure as part of the budgetary spending that will be in focus. Of course, you remember the National Assembly, or the Senate to be specific, has asked the Finance and the Budget and National Planning Ministers to step forward and explain how much of the 2017 budget goes into capital expenditure so far as the country needs to reflate the economy very quickly as well. Then we have the 2018 budget conclusion, as well as the ERGP implementation calendar. Those are very key on our own calendar as we step into the new month. And of course, the quarter. But as far as the calendar is concerned, what do we have? Let's give you a very quick review. We'll be talking about this. You need to mark a bit of this in your calendar. The Stock Exchange is holding a market data conference tomorrow to flag off the quarter and the month. As soon as everybody's get done with the business meetings today, the key market institutions will come together tomorrow to discuss the critical importance of market data mining for wealth creation. Then, of course, the central bank to release the financial stability report before the end of the week. And starting from Thursday, for 2 days, we have a Power in Nigeria energy conference taking place in Abuja,